Luckily, it's a reference to the aerodynamic, aerodynamic reference point, so it has nothing to do with the CG. The CG can travel into a point remains the same. So I'm going to apply this equation one more time. Yes, please. The circles mean that these are tied together, which means if the CG changed, this guy would change, alternatively this guy would change. Okay? But the neutral point would not. And of course, CL, the lift has nothing to do with CG. So I'm going to write this equation one more time with this fact in mind, is that if the CG travels, the blue things will travel, but the neutral point will not. I'm here putting two equalities. You're going to use only one of them. It's depending on the givens. So if you're given Cm alpha and Cl alpha, well, you're going to use this right-hand side. But if you're given Cm Cl, then this is the right-hand side that you're going to need, right? It's depending on the givens. So putting this equation again, like I said, this is fixed. It's the same started from the first line. This is why I needed to get the neutral point, because it's fixed. Now the CG, if the CG travels, then this guy will change, this guy will change, this guy will change. And I'm looking for the most forward CG location. Okay? So this is the most forward, and this is my unknown that I will get from this equation. So I need to prepare anything else. So this is why I needed the neutral point at the beginning. That's fine. Now I need either this or that. It's depending on the given. So let's just do both. Again, CL alpha is constant, right? So I'm looking for here, most forward, or this guy, most forward. So how do you get CM alpha most forward, or DCM by DCL most forward? Let's do this here, let's do that here. Any questions so far? So if I'm asking you, please get the XCG most forward, the most forward CG limit. First, get the neutral point. Second, after I show you how to get this guy, you immediately get the XCG most forward from this equation. So it's as if I'm applying this equation twice. One with the given CG already to get the neutral point. Then again, after I get the neutral point, I will get the CG, the new CG, okay? But of course, the characteristics will change, so you need to get the new characteristics. So how to get the new characteristics at the most forward CG location? Let's see. Well, what dictates the most forward CG location? What is this boundary for? It's trim, right? So trim means Cm is zero, right? Which is, if you have the Cm alpha thing, it's Cm node plus Cm alpha alpha plus Cm delta delta. Okay? Any question about that? Let's see what to substitute for. So, Cm naught and Cm delta, we'll assume that they don't change with the CG travel. But we cannot do that with the Cm alpha. We already know that the Cm alpha change with the CG travel, right? And actually, this is my goal. This is what I'm looking for. What is the Cm alpha at the most forward location? Can you tell me how to get the Cm alpha at the most forward location from here? What should I substitute by alpha for? Alpha, what should be alpha at this location? This is the maximum, right, for landing, because I'm concerned with the worst case scenario. So this is alpha max. Let me use what? Maybe this guy will help. So this is alpha max for store. To get the most forward, I'm looking for this guy, so I need to prepare everything else. Cm node doesn't change, Cm delta doesn't change, Cm is zero for trim, the alpha is the maximum alpha. What about delta? What about delta elevator? What value should we use for delta elevator, the length? The maximum, and the maximum limit is different from positive to negative. You're gonna use the maximum what? Maximum negative, awesome. So this is maximum, in my weird notation negative. The only unknown from this equation is CM alpha most forward. Please get it and the problem is solved. Okay? Any questions so far, please? Any question? We'll do a couple of examples, but please, if you have any questions, stop me. If you're given the CM versus CL characteristics, not CM alpha, it's very similar. I'm going to write down similar equations. CM is CM0 left plus dCM by dCM and CM plus CM delta delta. Again, CM is 0 left and CM delta would not change. And this guy is 0 for trim. And this guy is the most forward, which I'm looking for actually. So I need to prepare anything else. What about your CL? What value should you use for your CL? This is the maximum. You should be given the CL, the maximum ability of the airplane. So this is maximum, which corresponds to alpha maximum. It's just depending on the givens. And like we discussed, delta elevator should be the maximum in negative. So in either case, you can get the CG, XCG most forward. Let's have an example. You have some time to write. This is problem 2.4. Solved. We're going to solve most of the problems in medicine that are not solved. 86. So, it says the CM versus alpha curve for a large jet transport can be seen in figure 1. So, we'll draw this figure between CM and alpha. Given that the maximum angle of attack is 15. So it says that this is a stall. You can immediately see that the maximum angle of attack is 15 degrees. I will draw this figure now. It's maybe here is 0.1, 0.2, 0.3, 0.4, 0.5. Negative 0.1, 2, 3. And of course, this figure for CM, any figure for CM, any piece of information for CM has to be associated with a location for CG. So in the figure, on every figure like this, there is a stamp for the CG. XCG is as per the code here is given. This is given. We are also given the CL alpha, the whole airplane, the CL alpha characteristics. CL versus alpha, so this is CL, it's already given like this, CL equals 0.03 plus 0.08 alpha, and it says that alpha is in the B. We're also given that the elevator is between negative 15 degrees and 20 degrees. I think that's it. Let me just draw the figure. You all have to be parallel, of course, and every figure is corresponding to the value of delta elevated. Here it's written 10 degrees, 5 degrees, and so on and so. Here is the 0 degree, and here, and there. They're all parallel, all have the same slopes, because the slope is a very important piece of information, right? This is CMCG versus angle of attack. So the slope is CM alpha, dictating stability of the airplane. This is 0 degrees elevator, 5 degrees, negative 5 degrees elevator, and so on. So there is the last figure. We'll not do anything with it, I guess. So okay, three required. So these are the givens, okay? Just CL alpha curve, range of the elevator, CG, and CM alpha characteristics. What is required? Three things.